It's been called the second hardest job in the world. The mayor of New York City oversees the largest city in the country. 5 boroughs, more than 8 million people, and a police force that dwarfs some countries' armies. In November, New Yorkers will go to the polls and choose a new mayor. But the core of the race comes in the Democratic primary, which happens in June. With over 20 contenders in the race, let's look at who some of the candidates are. Andrew Yang is an American entrepreneur and the son of Taiwanese immigrants. After obtaining his law degree, he worked at one of the nation's most prestigious law firms. But after only a few months, he quit, calling it, quote, the 5 worst months of my life. Yang then founded a dot-com startup that failed and eventually started working at a friend's company that offered test prep to business students. He would go on to become the CEO of the company before it was acquired by Kaplan for millions of dollars, according to Yang. He then founded Venture for America, a company dedicated to helping young entrepreneurs build the skills they need to eventually start businesses of their own. He was named Presidential Ambassador for Global Entrepreneurship by President Obama.
I think that that's what really people want to preserve and sustain, which is that spirit of enterprise that's made this country great for its entire history.
In 2018, Yang made history, becoming the first Asian American man to run as a Democrat for president of the United States. His key campaign proposal then was a freedom dividend, or universal basic income. He does not suggest that for New Yorkers, but he is proposing giving those living in extreme poverty an average of $2,000 per year, which he estimates will help about 500,000 residents. Polls show Yang as the frontrunner, but he faces a diverse and deep field. Maya Wiley is a professor and lawyer who was born and raised in Washington, D.C. The daughter of famed civil rights leader George Wiley went on to use her Columbia Law degree to focus on the very issues that her father fought for. She worked for the ACLU and the NAACP, and in 2014 joined the de Blasio administration as counsel to the mayor.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. It's with great humility and great excitement that I accept this position.
She also was hired by MSNBC as a legal analyst until she announced her mayoral run. Maya Wiley is calling for an overhaul of the education system to address inequality in the city's schools. Eric Adams first started his community work fresh out of college when he was asked by activist and Reverend Herbert Daughtry to join the NYPD with the intent to make change in the department from within. For 22 years, the Brownsville native rose through the ranks of the NYPD, eventually becoming a captain while being one of the department's sharpest critics. He helped found 100 Blacks in Law Enforcement Who Care, a group made of NYPD officers advocating for police accountability.
Each officer who was inside the precinct on the day that this event took place should also be brought up on criminal charges and at a minimum administrative charges.
In 2006, he was elected to New York State Senate and later became Brooklyn Borough President. It's no surprise that one of Adams' top priorities is safety. He wants to build on the program that tracks crime and analyzes data to address the spike in shootings in New York. Scott Stringer was born and raised in New York City and has been in politics for most of his adult life. He started his career as legislative aide to Jerry Nadler. In 92, Stringer took over Nadler's vacated assembly seat. More than a decade later, the Washington Heights native won the race for Manhattan Borough President and currently serves as the city's comptroller. Since the beginning of his career, affordable housing has always been a top issue for Stringer. Stringer recently released an extensive plan declaring that housing is a right. Other candidates in the race include former Citigroup executive Ray McGuire, Secretary of Housing and Urban Development and OMB Director under President Obama, Sean Donovan, former New York City Sanitation Commissioner Catherine Garcia, and a local Brooklyn rapper, Paperboy Prince. Voters will be able to choose in a ranked choice format this year, which means second choice candidates could make a difference in the outcome. And whoever wins the Democratic primary will have to face a Republican in November. Guardian Angels founder Curtis Sliwa is in that race.
Disastrous mayoralty of Bill de Blasio. He has so wrecked this city. Every way you look, every visible sign, and there's such hopelessness and despair.
Whoever is the new occupant of Gracie Mansion will oversee a city that's still in the middle of a health and economic crisis, losing over 500,000 jobs in 2020, according to the state's Department of Labor. It's safe to say the next mayor of New York City will have a lot more on their plate than usual.
Hey, NBC News viewers, thanks for checking out our YouTube channel. Subscribe by clicking on that button down here and click on any of the videos over here to watch the latest interviews, show highlights, and digital exclusives. Thanks for watching.